My first question is, within Mediterranean environment, what does it mean? We are all Italian, or talking all the population that are around this very big lake, in the different but similar condition in order to the climate, first of all. But for me, it's important to raise with you the thing of Sereni, that was very important scientist about Mediterranean landscape. Knowing the peculiar feature of a natural or urban artificial landscape, then identifying it with a feeling of belonging as a place bearing culture, tradition, has always been the link between the human beings and their territory, geographic context. That means that there is a very close relation between the context and the way of life, the way of building of population. In my opinion, we are aware that what makes a home familiar is not the small size of one house, but mostly the emotion that our sense can grasp and dig into our memories, linking the space of our houses to the territorial and landscape that they belong to, becoming an integral part of the complementary relationship between nature and artificiality. We can recognize Mediterranean, all of us, we can recognize a Mediterranean environment also if it is not in our country. This is in Greece, but Turkish people, Italian people could recognize that it's a Mediterranean landscape. But what are the characteristics of the Mediterranean way of build urban contexts, build home houses, build the place where stay? In general, we have a night density, inner courtyards, narrow street, small windows. This is related to the climate. The result is, in general, the same. Also, if with different cultures. In Venice, for example, we have a very small street called Calle, and a few large space called Campo. I don't know if you know that in Venice, also if it is an Italian, very important city, we can find only one piazza. La piazza, the place in Venice is only San Marco Plaza. Followed space called Campo. And in general, the density is very, very high. The buildings are very close between each other. This is a piazza, the holy piazza in Venice, that all the world know very well. In Campania, in my region, we have the very famous island of Capri. And in Capri too, we have a night density, flat room, and domes. Generally, domes are for the church, but not only for the church. Also for vernacular building. And we know that in all Mediterranean, domes are characteristic of the landscape, of a characteristic of culturally rich in tradition, in our tradition. Domes change a lot, but in general, all domes are I say as a bioclimatic machines, because the hot air could go up and turn and change and refresh the ambient inside. Different domes are for little vernacular building in my region. In the picture, in this picture, are truly the Alberobello they show before. Probably, sorry, this one are the Alberobello. Truly are an interesting conic domes. They are realized without mortar, only rocks without mortar. This one, this other case are in my region. And in particular, this type is very traditional, is very a model that you could find in all Mediterranean, I think. But regarding the interior of the houses, I think that you know the characteristic of Pompeii houses, building in stone walls, by rocks from Vesuv, volcano Vesuv, and other rocks in the area, Neapolitan area, that we have a characteristic tough yellow stone that is very easy to cut and is very resistant. And in our houses, in the ancient houses in our tradition, it doesn't change a lot in this time. The entrance, the atrium inside the house, in the middle of the atrium, there is a fountain and a big court with the columns around, that is the silo, the garden, different type of garden. If you visit Pompeii now, it's very interesting. A few days ago, they informed me that there are studying very well also the type of vegetation, the greenery inside the court. It's a very interesting research that are in itinerary now. But Pompeii was interesting also for Le Corbusier. Houses of Pompeii were studied by contemporary architects. And there are the sketch from Le Corbusier in 2021. Is the houses of a tragic poetry in Pompeii Scavi. And it's interesting that he put vegetables in the middle of the court and simplified the pistillium. So few columns, but it's interesting that he introduced the lecture, typological lecture, you can see. In the Mediterranean environment, it's very important the shade to cool. And we know well that because in our country, it's more important to the fresh than to help the apartment, the houses. So the court could resolve this problem, creating in any case a wall in shade and a wall in the sun. So in this case, the hair is obliged to turn and refresh, because we know that the hot air go up and the fresh air is more arrived in the soil. And this is a sketch, there are the sketch with the system of the air circulation. And it's very important. So it's very important the presence of the tree foreshadow too. The wind too is very important. In our country there are not so many systems, but I know that in our country are more diffused this system of air circulation. The fresh air that is on the soil is obliged to go up and generate a circulation of air, refreshing these walls in order to have two walls and a space for the refreshment. During the day, this is the circle line of the wind, and during the night, the system is changed, and so the refreshing is also during the night. In this kitchen, you have the Mediterranean house, the cube. We say the Mediterranean cube, this kind of building. They are ever the stair outside. The stair outside, because the system of construction is very easy, with the module, the cubic module, repeating, replying for in height, large, and the stairs stay outside in order to have a system of a building more easy, because the structure of the stairs is could not generate the complication in the structure internal of the building. So the stairs are outside, and in general are with this arch, the space under the stairs. It is useful for deposit or other thing, for a shadow, for other activity in the Mediterranean area. There are the vernacular rural building, so in general there are in Campania. The Mediterranean rural building in Campania are memorized also from sketch pictures and also book by travelers of Middle Europe. In particular, is very famous Don Wolfgang von Goethe, that have a trip in Italy. This is in red, you have is a travel, and he wrote the Viaggio in Napoli, Travel in Naples, a book dedicated, an Italianish prize. This is a record of the situation at the end of the 18th century. It's very important also for the sketch, for the pictures that are documents very important for us. A document very important also is the sketch by Friedrich Schinkel and Joseph Hoffmann, that are two very important architects in the area of Middle Europe during the 17th century. And in this sketch, that are very detailed, we can the author shows something that for them are particular, strange, are characteristic that they have not in their countries. In particular, we can see the simple and modular geometries The walls built in stone, the small windows, the flat rooms or domes, like in this case, external stairs, the lotus and the pergolas. I'm very nice because pergolas in the imaginary of pergolas with for wine with grapes are very impressive for the imaginary of North Europe or Central North Europe. But the Pompey houses were the model, the example also for contemporary architects, as Adolf Loos, that designed Villa Mossi in the Lido di Venezia. So we are in Venice. You can see there the some of the characteristics that during the past time, these people coming from Austria, coming from Germany, recognize as characteristical Mediterranean expression in our houses. But also Italian during the fascism, this same characteristic for the colonial building in Africa. So this is a project of Luigi Ficinato, and it's a modern interpretation with new materials, with concrete. But something come back again is not equipped with peristylium column around, but only in the coin, very height, with the light can pass in this case. So new innovation in tradition also for Pio Ponti, that you know certainly as an important Italian designer during the fascism epoch. And in this case you can see the project of the Villa alla Pompeiana, is the red is the color of Pompeii, and so for the facade is red, in interior is white, with the big court, the fountain, the basin, water basin inside, and the some elements also the only one floor. But in Naples we have a very important architect, many appreciated probably in Italy, not much new in exterior countries, but is a Neapolitan engineer that have a very big sensibility for architecture, for landscape. And this is a project of him in Naples, near the coast, Mare Chiaro. And also in this case, we can see an interpretation of some elements of traditional vernacular rural building. Also, very important case of Adalberto Libera in Capri, La Casa Malaparte, is great on the rocks, but very visible for the red color, for this impact, this big building on the coast. But I think, I don't know. So in Italy, we have a peninsula with a climate very different. And I look for the climate in Turkey, and it's more regular, I can say. In Italy, we have very type of climate along the peninsula, because we have the high mountains, the Alps, that are from high mountains in Europe, but we have Sicily, and we have Sardinia, that are more hot. So change a lot. Along the peninsula, we have mountain, so change the climate too. The length of Italy is 1,500 kilometers. And so you can see that our climate change is similar to Africa there, and it is similar to Germany there. So it's an interesting condition. Interesting condition of climate, and interesting condition geographical, because we have hubs, we have happenings, we have only one big plain. This is the plain of the greatest river Italian, that is Po. And so in this plain, there are a lot of rural construction, totally different of the construction that we are along this little plain that we are along the peninsula. In Italy, we have a lot of sites protected by UNESCO, in the list UNESCO. Because we have a great variety of landscape that are representative of different regions, and we have in different way of life in order to adapt to condition geographical, to condition climate condition, and also from cultural condition of Italy, because along the history of our country, we have a lot of different people, different domination that came from south and north, because north was separated in very few, in a lot of little state, but the south of Italy was an unique territory, and Naples was the capital of this territory. Between the UNESCO cultural landscape in Italy, we have very interesting and famous in the world landscape sites for tourism, as La Costiera Amalfitana, that is in the list of UNESCO starting from 1997. And the reason, because this territory was listed, and that the community, human community, stayed there also if the mountain was close to the sea. And so determined the difficulty to live on this side, but the relationship with the sea and the commerce by sea generated a particular territory with the terraces where they have, starting from the Middle Age, the little terrace with hurt to cultivate. Situation similar to Costiera Amalfitana is in Liguria, in the north of Italy, where Also in this case, the mountain, the colline, the hills arrive directly on the sea. This is the case of Cinque Terre. Cinque Terre means five earth, but are five little villages related between the very strict between each other. And one year after Costiera Amalfitana, in the same province, this is the province of Salerno, also the Cilento, Vallo di Diano, National Park are listed for UNESCO. This cultural landscape is important also for archaeology. In the Cilento was the boundary between the Greek colonies of Magna Graecia and the indigenous Tuscan and Lucanian people who have in interior of our region. In Italy, we have also another cultural landscape that is different. So, is a landscape diffuse. This one of a sacred mountains of Piedmont Lombardy. That means that in these two regions, we have a series of separated complex located on the mountain with the temples that represent the last time of Christ. It is very important for the Christian religion. La Val d'Orta is in the Tuscany, and I think that all of you have not visited my new this paisage, this landscape. And it's very important because this is an artificial landscape. This hill, all these hills are designed, are transformed by human work. In order to have the soil for agriculture. And in Tuscany too, in 2030, Villa Medici and gardens, that means a complex of villas and gardens, founded the project, the design from a very important a noble family of Medici, appeared very interesting for UNESCO for this character, common character of project that lies the art. Artificial to natural. And one of the last is the landscape of Vineyard, landscape of Piedmonte, and Langhe, Moero, and Monferrato are territory close to the castle, this green hill. And then produced one of the best wine of Italy. And staying in the topic of wine, we have the Colline del Prosecco di Conegliano e Valdobbiadene. And also in this case, we have the Green Hill with vineyard and the rural little houses. In general, the rural construction, the traditional construction, are related very, very strongly related to the territory, to the nature of the soil, to the geography, to the climate. The territory of my region, our region, represents in Italy an important resource for agricultural production, both for quantity and variety of product. In fact, its etymology, Campania Felix, that was the name, the Roman, for my reason, refers to the fertility of the soils the origin of the fertility is for the volcanic origin, for the richness in material, in minerals of the soils. And so it is not a coincidence that the slopes of Monte Vesuvio, that is the only active volcano on land in Europe, is the region with the highest density of population in Europe. So that means that volcano, dangerous volcano, is not sleeping, is not dead, it's only sleeping, but there are the highest density population in Europe. That means that this territory have some characteristic of fertility, very, very important. We don't renounce to that. I showed before the Cilento Amalfi Coast, there are two territory in Salerno province, that is south of Naples. And it's very important this territory for our tourism, of course, are very, very famous, Amalfi, Positano, Ravello, are villages very important, they are in Amalfi Coast. Lento are territory close to the sea, but also hills inside, in the interior. And that is interesting in this an Italian from our culture, Mediterranean culture, are the terraces. Now with olives, tree of olives, tree of lemon, and so on. And thanks to this adaptiveness over time, it was established a typical Mediterranean agricultural structure based on the field wood system, ensuring a population variety of agricultural products, including oil, wheat, wine, vegetables, beans, meat, milk, and cheese, firewood, and other underground products. The network of cities and rural building was organized according to the agrarian structure developed over the century. In general, all the artifacts are the building with a very small size connected to each other according to the crop and the noble family they belong to. And there is not a coincidence that this kind of product that you have in Turkey too are famous in all the world for the oil from secular century olives in Filenton. Or lemon in the Costa d'Amalfi, cultivated from this is in the resources. In the building and the very little small on these terraces. So we have shared, me as a coordinator, my department was shared by region Campania and Ministry of Culture to analyze the architecture of this territory in a province of Salerno, in Cilento in particular. And we start with an analysis with a sketching on site, of course. We stay a lot of time, a lot of day on site as a travelers of a grand tour, regarding studying, sketching this building in relation with the landscape. And these are some photos and sketch that was the base of our research. And there are other sketch and photos, but I think for you could be interesting that at least we have a type of manual with guidelines for project for regeneration, for rehabilitation of this ancient building that often are abandoned. And so in this case, we are an example of some element that we can conserve or not. And you can read other contribution in this manual for recovery of rural architecture in Campania, in the Vesuvian area and in the Cilento area. It is important that there are spontaneous vernacular buildings that now are considered too much as very, very nice architecture. But this thing, this picture, this image, I think is the best innovation in our research, because at the end we affirmed that it is not possible to consider the houses, vernacular houses, traditional houses, joined from their position in the landscape, because changed in the form and the relation with the context. So this is the new base for the study in our region on rural building. Starting from this our research, the rural building are studied connected to territory. Our study identified different building type, system, and construction elements with a distinct recurring feature through the territory, therefore allowing to recognize homogeneous classing according to the different structure, size, dimension, organization. So it's interesting that the population settled in this park is called the Park of Cilento because it's under the protection of the Ministry of Culture. So this territory is a park, regional park, and the population settled in this park reshaped their home vita space in order to ensure their food self-sufficiency in all season, developing a time of transversal economy, strongly integrated with nature, combining the Mediterranean pasture with the hills and mountain pastures. So, in conclusion, I show you some publication about her. In 2015, we have the first manuale per la realizzazione di interventi per recupero, recovery of architecture and cultural rural landscape in this area. with other colleagues. This is the group, the name of my colleagues. And 1 year after, we have another conference and another little book about study on architecture coming from experience coming from all of Italy. There are two volumes of this manuale that we write, we produce at the end of our research for Ministry of Cultural Heritage and Activities and Tourism and Campania Region that we guide. In this book, we have also some abacus from masonry elements recurrent in region before were masonry from Cilento, this one, and this one from Vesuvian area are volcanic rock, more dark, as you can see. And in the agricultural landscape, we analyze also some elements as one more the stairs external scale. It's very important in vernacular architecture the correspondence between object of living and building type that have more than ever implicit in this particular field of the bit, while validated choice and a posteriori interpretation reread the vocation and identify formal solution with clear, precise connotation, almost elementary in the structure. Are a measure on the evolution of the landscape and the meaning that the humanization of landscape makes many true living. So the causative solution became a language strictly related to the territory. The invariance between these two contexts in Campania, Vesuvius area and Cilento, only apparently different, but very similar in mechanism and material definition lies in the link between the way of living and the landscape. From this unique admirable relationship synthesis of living and building, the name of the house emerges, which has a mirror of the landscape as an intrinsic cultural value of physical, geographic environment and human context. In addition, the material reading on rural architecture and the study of the external and internal spatial organization of the various house types, it revealed the important production network that characterizes this area. In fact, albeit simple, the logic composition of artifacts is direct testimony of the relationship between architecture and production, therefore between living and production. So the in general, the simplicity is the law of vernacular construction. And we talk about that also in an international conference. And we present this guideline for the development of Italian rural landscape, starting from our pilot experience in Regione Campania. And it's very interesting, I think, in fact, it's the same that in the rural areas, the link between every article created at different scales by human communities. It's very tight. Winged, cultivated, and wet field. Building a pergola or dry stone walls to create a terrace building a cellar or farmhouse. All of them have the same adaptive and mitigating methods with respect to the natural environment. So this is the reason because the UNESCO recognizes the value of this landscape. But it's very important to recognize the UNESCO recognized also the Mediterranean diet. It is very related to our topic, to home, to houses, to landscape, to geography, and to rural life. So in 1998, you know that the Mediterranean diet, according to the international community, involves a set of skill knowledge, rituals, symbols, and traditions concerning crops, harvesting, fishing, animal husbandry, conservation, cooking, and particularly the sharing of consumption of food. The sharing and consumption of the food is a characteristic of our common culture, Mediterranean. Eating together is the foundation of the cultural identity. So pay attention to the cooking space in houses and the continuity of community through the Mediterranean basin. The Mediterranean diet emphasizes the value of hospitality, neighborliness, intercultural dialogue and creativity, and way of life guided by respect for diversity. It plays a vital role of cultural space, festival, and celebration, bringing together people of all ways, condition, and social class. So it's very democratic way of life. It includes the craftsmanship and production of traditional receptacles for transport, preservation, consumption of the food, including ceramic plate and glasses. So that is not product to heat, but is all the system. In the current global environmental crisis, the rural landscape is once again considered an asset of man, special for its cultural and spiritual values as a fundamental scenario to build individual and collective life. Mediterranean diet, you know, is simplified by this pyramid. As conclusion, in the area of commercial globalization, both in the industrial West, particularly in this period of the war in Ukraine, individuals and communities can still place themselves in time and space. Is there as knowledge, tradition, a culture that in ancient time and it wrote in a specific geographical area, directly or indirectly influencing our way of thinking, acting, and our perspective. The sense of belonging to a community is innate, specifically regarding our species, human species, which, thanks to language and development of verbal communication, also in and here's my speech heading to create a relation with you, continues to pass from generation to generation the culture of environmental adaptation through cognitive process and the practical abilities that evolve by generation to generating tools, machine, and produce increasingly complex and advanced. The relationship built between man and nature in a specific context make us the successor of a series of choices imposed by economy, social community needs, which our pedestrians are made in the management over their settled territories, where they have decided to establish their bond, therefore placing in those territories their cultural roof. We find today the value of our collective heritage. And to finish, an invitation, because we